Today I will discuss about Michaelson-Morley experiment. This experiment was performed in 1887 to prove the existence of a hypothetical medium that was named ether. It was considered that ether medium is a solid, rigid, invisible, transparent, massless, perfectly non-resistive, continuous, stationary, having very high elasticity and negligible density. All light or heavy bodies, including Earth, can move through this medium, and this medium provides a frame, a stationary frame, to all the moving bodies. And this frame is known as ether frame or absolute frame of reference. It is a light source, and light is incident on a partially silver plate. This is partially silver plate, and it is inclined at 45 degrees. And due to this partially silver plate, some light are reflected and some are refracted, and there is a mirror M1 and there is a mirror M2, and this is origin point. Separation of this mirror from origin point is L, and also distance of M2 from O is L. This experiment is moving with velocity V, as V represents the velocity of Earth. It means Earth is moving by velocity V, and with respect to universe, this experiment is also moving with velocity V. Suppose after time t dash, this mirror is shifted at mirror M dash. As we know, it is moving by velocity V, and light ray is incident at M1 dash and reflected like this, and this point O is shifted at O dash. This mirror M2 is shifted at M2 dash. Now suppose the velocity of light is c, and we know that velocity of this experiment is v. In this direction, light wave is moving by c velocity, and experiment is moving by v velocity, and direction of both are same. It means velocity of light with respect to this experiment, it should be c minus v. It means time taken from O to M2, it should be L upon C minus V, distance upon velocity, and time taken from M2 to O, it should be L upon C plus V, as now light wave, direction of light wave is this, and experiment is moving in this direction. It means both are opposite, and in opposite direction, the velocity of respective velocity of light wave with respect to this experiment, it should be C plus V. It means the time for light wave from O to M2 and M2 to O, it should be T1, and it is L upon C minus V plus L upon C plus V. And we can take LCM C minus V, C plus V, it becomes L C plus V plus L C minus V, or we can write L C plus L V plus L C minus L V upon C square minus V square, and T1 equal to L V cancel out, twice L C upon C square minus V square. Now we can divide by c square, numerator and denominator divided by c square, it becomes twice lc upon c square upon c square minus v square upon c square, and 1c cancel out, it becomes t1 equal to twice l upon c upon c square upon c square becomes 1 minus v square upon c square, and we can also write twice l upon c 1 minus v square upon c square to the power minus 1. Now we can apply binomial theorem. We know that 1 plus x to the power n equal to 1 plus nx plus, ignoring the higher terms, but we can apply this binomial theorem when x is very, very less than 1. Here c square is very, very greater than 2v square, it means this term becomes less than 1, it means we can apply binomial theorem here, and if we apply binomial theorem here, then minus 1 is multiplied by minus v square upon c square, and t1 becomes twice l upon c 1 plus v square upon c square. This is equation number 1. T2 represents the time of light velocity from O to M1 dash and M1 dash to O dash, and we know that velocity of M1 to M1 dash is v and time is t dash, it means M1 M1 dash becomes v into t dash, and O M1 dash, O M1 dash, now this is light and velocity of light is c, time is again t dash, and M1 O is equal to L. In triangle O M1 M1 dash, O M1 dash square equal to M1 M1 dash square plus O M1 square. O M1 dash means C square T dash square. M1 M1 dash means V square T dash square plus L square, or we can write C square minus V square into T dash square equal to L square, and T dash square equal to L square upon C square minus V square, and T dash is L upon under root. We can take C square outside from the bracket and it becomes C. C square upon C square is 1 minus V square upon C square to the power half, and we can write L upon C 1 minus V square upon C square to the power minus half. Now again we can apply binomial theorem in this term, and minus half is multiplied by minus V square upon C square, and it becomes L upon C 1 plus half V square upon C square. This is time of light ray from O to M1 dash, and M1 dash to O dash again equal to L upon C 1 plus V square upon 2C square, and total time if represented by T2, it becomes twice L upon C 1 plus V square upon 2C square. Suppose this is light ray 2 and this is light ray 1. Now we calculate the time difference between the light ray 1 and light ray 2. The time difference between light ray 1 and 2, it should be delta t equal to t1 minus t2, where t1 is twice l upon c 1 plus v square upon c square, minus t2 is twice l upon c 1 plus v square upon 2c square. Now we can take twice l upon c common, and it becomes 1 plus v square upon c square minus 1 minus v square upon 2c square, 1 cancel out, and it becomes twice l upon c v v square upon c minus v square upon 2c square means v square upon 2c square. 2 cancel out and it becomes v square l upon c cube. This is time difference between light ray 1 and 2. And now we can calculate path difference between both rays. Path difference. And it should be time difference into velocity of light. And time difference is v square l upon c cube into c. It becomes v square l upon c square. Now the experiment is rotated by 180 degree. And if experiment is rotated by 180 degree, then effective path difference. Effective path difference becomes delta p minus delta p, because all positive becomes negative and it is equal to twice of delta p, or we can say twice v square l upon c square. And by the help of this path difference, we can calculate the fringe shift. When the experiment is rotated by 180 degree, we can calculate the number of fringe shift, and number of fringe shift delta n, it should be path effective path difference. Effective path difference upon wavelength of light. And effective path difference is twice v square l upon c square lambda. And the length of this experiment is 11 meter, and v, which is velocity of earth, it is 3 into 10 to the power 4 meter per second. Velocity of light is 3 into 10 to the power 8 meter per second, and wavelength is 5500 angstrom. Now we can put all data in this, and fringe shift becomes 2, 3 into 10 to the power 4 square, 11 upon 3 into 10 to the power 8 square, and 5500 10 to the power minus 10 in meter. And when we solve it, it becomes equal to 0.4. It means there is no change in shift. Not a single fringe is shifted when the experiment is rotated by 180 degree. While the surrounding medium of this experiment is stable, that is ether, and we rotate this experiment by 180 degree, that's why there should be a large number of fringe shift. But in this experiment, not a single fringe is shifted when this experiment is rotated by 180 degree. Michaelson and Morley performed this experiment at a different places and at different timings, but there will be no change in this result. That's why this experiment was declared failed.